Okay, I'm back here at the welding dump in the great spot that I found. So today I'm going to dig right here. As you probably remember from the previous video, I dug right over here and tunneled it 3 feet over. So right about where this stump is the wall. So I'm going to dig out about a 5 foot square right in here. Well, I've only gotten about 7 inches and already pulled out an intact bottle. Hard to imagine. Looks like a Brown Bottling Works from Scotland Neck. No lip chips. I don't see anything else wrong with it either. So that's a good easy score. Probably the easiest spot in this whole dump. And dry and just only several inches and you hit solid glass. Whoa, a whole coke only 3 inches deep? Well, it looks damaged. But it's from welding and it's practically clear. That's kind of unusual. Just pulled out a whole Chiro Cola with the cap still on it. I don't see any cracks in it either. Looks like a probable hole one right here. And it is. Well, no, not quite, but pretty darn close anyway. This is obviously where the Chiro Cola Company dumped. So many of these in this section. And there's another hole one with the cap still on it. Okay, what do we got right over here? I think it's a flask. Yep, it's the really basic, boring variety. No embossing. Okay, I think we might have one here. Well, pretty close anyway. It's just another Chiro Cola. Okay, I got another from Scotland Neck. It's all there, but it does have several cracks in it. But I think I'll still bring it home. 20 minutes later, I finally found another intact bottle. It's a hobble skirt this time. It's got some serious fractures in the base. But you're not going to believe where it's from. Fargo. It's not North Dakota marked either, so that might make it a rare variation. Okay, it took a 5 minute break. Let's get back to it. Okay, found one of these Pepsis from Weldon. It's the weird short neck variety. Of course the top's broken off, but that's a $300 bottle if it wasn't damaged. So I'm still going to bring it home. Just found a great one. Hopefully it's not cracked. Oh, damn it. It does have a crack. Looks like a flash crack too, because it becomes invisible when you turn it. Yeah, I don't know. It's got two cracks and a bruise out of it, but I'm thinking it's still worth about $40 even like that. I think I just found a dime. Let me see if I can clean it off. I doubt I'll be able to read it right now. I can sort of read it, but not quite. Maybe when I get home I can clean it up better. Found a broken Virginia Fruit Juice Company from Norfolk. I found probably 100 of these broken in here. But every one of them was clear except for this one. It's a nice shade of aqua. Pretty rare in that color. Okay, it's almost too dark to dig anymore. Just found this Henderson Pepsi. Top's broken off. I was looking down here for some script embossing first and I saw some kind of a pink thing in there and I was like, what is that? There's a snake in there. It's hibernating in this empty bottle. Some people would say, no, that's just a worm. No, it's definitely a snake. Probably wonders what's going on. It's winter time. It wants to be in the warm dirt. Well, I almost sold one of these one time, but I figure I'll probably just let it go, because who knows how to feed a snake this tiny. Okay, coming back again. It's only 44 degrees outside right now, so I'm obviously not that excited. But I'll get excited soon, because once I get into this bottle layer again, how can I not be happy with a dump like this? Dug up another snake, and it looks like it might be a poisonous one. But it's so small and cold, it's probably not ready to try and bite me. But it's definitely something I've got to get out of here. Okay, just found a Chirocola that looks to be intact. Nope, it's got a fracture right there. But still, that's in pretty good shape for this dump, so I'm going to bring that one back. Now I dug up a walking snake. What is up with all these reptiles in this hole? Sorry I woke you up from your hibernation. Okay, this is starting to get crazy. We found another lizard of another type. Look at the colors on that thing. This one's not really ready to wake up yet. There's one I've never seen before. Queen Cola. Would have been a perfect candidate for a drinking glass. Cutting it off right where that ring is. Not doing very well today, but this looks like it might be a whole one. Okay, we got a hobble skirt with just the lip sheared off. What city is it from? Wow, that's the first one I've seen that says Coca-Cola and script on the bottom. Oh my god, it doesn't say Coca-Cola, it just says C and C in the Coca-Cola script, but with just the two C's? That's really unusual. Gotta save this one for sure. We've got two of them showing up here. I think one of them at least is gonna be intact. Nope, not that one. No, that one's not whole either. Okay, we're getting some Virginia bottles out of here. This is the first Gingura I've seen in here. First one I've ever found, from Richmond anyway. So that would have been a pretty good one. And then we have Franklin Bottling Works from Franklin, Virginia. It's the first one of these I've ever seen. For real. We've got a fifth reptile showing up. It's trying to get away from me. This is a big one here. Well, considering how small the rest were, it's actually got a hold of something down there. I can't even get it out. It doesn't want to be out in the cold, and I don't blame it. It was a cold day today. Is that another one of those blind snakes? If so, it's the biggest one I've ever seen. They're usually half this size. Come on, I'm trying to save your life. Quit digging in here. Pink and silver. I think it tried to bite me. We got ourselves a trickster here. Looks like an intact soda bottle, but there's no embossing. So you serious diggers know what that means. It's just a Pluto water. You know what I do with those, don't you? Okay, we might have a whole one coming out here. Yep. It's another Chiro Cola with the cap on it. It's beginning to be more of a reptile roundup than a bottle dig. Here's number 6. Come on, get out of there. Can't stay here anymore. And now another creepy crawly. These things are sort of poisonous too. So definitely want to get that out of here. I think I see a whole one in there. That's just another Chiro. But it's intact. And 1 minute later we got another one. Very strange how there's so many of these in here and they all have the caps on them. Another Virginia bottle that I've also never seen. I think it says Greater Richmond Bottling Company. And of course Richmond, Virginia down here. It's damaged a little too much. I don't think I'm going to bring that one back though. Okay, another first from Virginia. I got a little bit excited when I first saw this. But then I was like, wait a minute. That's just a celery cola. It's a beautiful bottle, but it's quite common. Worth maybe $8. Okay, I just popped out another one with the cap on it. It's another Chiro Cola, but this one is not the semi-teal one. This one must be from Rocky Mount or some other place. But it's full of water. Got the original cap.